Guys, my name is Shrikant Edam and hope you all doing well. Welcome to hardware class part 2. Today we are going to discuss about the processor and RAM. Normally processor will look like this, okay? So when you buy a processor, it will have few details on it. Details like model and processor speed. This is Intel Xeon processor and with a speed of 3.5 GHz. It will have a serial number as well, okay? So what is the use of processor? Processor is also known as CPU, Central Processing Unit, and called as brain of computer. It responds and processes the instructions given by the user. So primary functions of the processor is to fetch, decode, execute and write back. So for example, if a user is trying to open any application, so that is a command for the processor. It responds to it, okay? It will fetch that instruction and decode it and execute and open the application for the user. Processor speed is measured in megahertz and gigahertz in computer's internal clock. Okay, this is these are the units which are being measured. 1 hertz, 1 kilohertz, 1 megahertz, 1 gigahertz, 1 terahertz, 1 petahertz and 1 exahertz. These are the units available. Okay, what exactly is megahertz? 1 million cycles per second is called as 1 megahertz. Here 1 megahertz is used to measure the transmission speed, okay, of electronic devices. Normally in electronic devices, the transmission speed is measured in megahertz and gigahertz and in Hebow cycles. Okay, so how fast it can fetch and decode, execute the instructions given by the user and transfer it back to the user totally depend upon the processor speed. Okay, processor speed means here on the processor we saw 3.5 gigahertz, right? So that is the processor speed. So how fast it can execute the command given by the user. Both megahertz and gigahertz are used to measure CPU speed. That's right. A 1 megahertz clock means some number of bits which is being carried. It can carry and can be processed at least 1 million times per second and execute. The more the speed, the more data it can carry. Okay, so here we have small image, it will be easy to understand. Here you can see 60 megahertz. You can think it as a speed limit. Okay, 60 megahertz is a speed limit and amount of data is being carried by a trucks. More the bits and speed, better performance. Here the speed limit is 60 megahertz. For example, if it is if I am having a 32-bit processor, it can carry 8-bit of processor, it can carry only this much amount of data, and 16-bit can carry this much amount of data. 32-bit processor can carry more data at 60 speed. Okay, so the more the speed increases, and if for example if I have a 64-bit processor with more speed, for example 3.5 gigahertz processor having more speed and it can carry 64-bit data, just imagine the speed. Okay, it can execute the command very fast. The 2 gigahertz clock means at least 2 billion times. Okay, the at least is because multiple operations often occur in one cycle. In one cycle it can process more commands and we can work on multiple applications. More the speed, better the performance. So we have different type of processor as well, like different models, Intel and AMD. Okay, these are the brands which are available in processor. Both manufacture single and multi-core processor. So in Intel we have Celeron, Pentium and Core model processor. In AMD we have Sempron, Athlon and Pentium in AMD processors. So what exactly do you mean by single and multi-core processor? So for example, this is a processor, guys. On it you will find small white color part that is called core. Okay, here it is in yellow color, but on the processor you will find yellow white color part. So this is for example, it is a physical part which we can see. Okay, and it will have thread as well. Thread is a logical part of the core that executes every command and gives output. Okay, so whatever the command is given by the user, it the thread will execute it. okay, and gives the output. For example, if a core has two threads, it means it can handle two separate tasks at once using two logical threads. Okay, for example, the user is giving two separate tasks at once, so the core already have two threads, right? So it can process two separate tasks at once and using the logical threads and process the command very fast. So earlier it was used to called a thread, but now the latest term we are using it as hyper threading. The term has been changed. In Intel, hyper threading term is being used. For example, if I am going to buy i7 processor, these are the specifications which is mentioned. It has 4 cores, overclocking capable. Overclocking capable means I can use more performance. For example, if it's 3.5 gigahertz processor, I can use more than that speed. I can use it up to 4.5. Okay, Intel hyper threading technology for 8-way multitasking. Hyper threading, it means it has 8 threads. It can process 8 tasks at a time. Intel Turbo Boost technology. So using Intel Turbo Boost, I can enable my overclocking capable. And it supports DDR4 and DDR3 RAM. In case if I have a processor with a single core, what will happen? It will process only one instruction at a time. And it has to be, we need to wait because one operation to become over before another operation could begin. For example, if I am trying to open one application, okay, and again before the application open, again I am trying to open some other application, it will not open. The first application will open, then only after some time the second application will open. So it will be slower. But comparing it, if you are going to use multi-core, it will have more features because multi-core will have processor with two cores, and two cores have four threads. Multi-processor, multiple instructions can perform multitasking. So simultaneously we can open multiple applications and it will be very fast. Because here we are using hyper threading technology, it is nothing guys, it means it will have more threads. So AMD also using the multi threading technology, and it is called as clustered multi threading technology. Different terms, same thing. For example, if I have i3 processor, it will have 2 cores and 4 threads. i5 processor, 4 cores and 4 threads. i7, 4 cores and 8 threads. That is what mentioned on this picture. i7 processor with 4 cores, 8 threads, right? So whenever you're going to buy a processor, you need to make a note of all these things. Next topic is RAM, guys. So here in the screenshot you can see different type of model of RAMs, right? Here we have few old models of RAM which we don't use it anymore, like HD RAM which we were using in P1, P2, P3 computers, P4 computers. Here this is a 184 pin RAM, which means DDR1 RAM, and here we have some micro DIMM RAM which are used in laptops. 240 pin RAM, DDR2 RAM. Okay, so every RAM will have a small cut on it. Okay, did you observe? Two cut, one cut, two cut, and this gold pins. In 2002, they have released DDR1 RAM. In 2004 they released DDR2 RAM. In DDR7 they released 2003, so DDR3 RAM. Currently we are using DDR4 RAM. Okay, this is the latest RAM which we are using right now. Every RAM technology is better than the previous one and runs on low voltage. So here DDR4 is better than DDR3, and DDR3 is better than DDR2. DDR2 is better than DDR1. Okay, so it will it is faster than this. DDR4 is faster than DDR3, okay, and it will use low voltage, and the data transfer speed is double than DDR3. So that is what mentioned here. Every RAM technology is better than the previous one and runs on low voltage. HD RAM. HD RAM means the RAM which was used in P1, P2, P3, P4 RAM. So what exactly stands for? Synchronous Dynamic Random Access Memory. It works in a single data rate, so it performs one task in one clock cycle. So this RAM is slow, guys. It will perform only one task at one time. Okay, so that is a disadvantage of the HD RAM. That is the reason they introduced DDR1 RAM to work fast. DDR means double data rate. It will transfer the speed, it has more transfer speed, and it will carry more data, double data. This RAM consumes lesser energy, works faster than the HD RAM. It is highly capable of transferring data at double speed and increases performance. So if you come to DDR2 RAM, it is better than DDR1 RAM. Okay, so it will transfer the data at double speed again. DDR3 also does the same thing comparing to DDR2, and power consumption is also slow. Here we have data transfer speed of 800 to 1600 megabits per second. Then we have DDR4. The latest one is DDR4, and it is best among the variations. DDR4 was introduced in 2013. This RAM is highly efficient and offer better scalability, reliability and performance. So here we have less chances of failure in case if you are using DDR4, because it uses less voltage. Okay, and data transfer speed is also good. Good performance will be given in DDR4. If your motherboard has been designed for DDR3 technology, then it will not support DDR4 modules of RAM. This is because the location of the notch is different for each one of them, and different memory technologies are not compatible with each other. This is the reason why a motherboard usually supports just one type of memory technology. What exactly it means is, on your motherboard, if it is designed for DDR3, then it will use only DDR3. Okay, DDR4 will have a different type of model RAM slot. It will be not be fit for this DDR3 module. So that is the reason, in case if you want to use DDR4 model, you have to change entire motherboard. So this is how RAM looks, guys. Let me zoom out. This is a 4GB RAM and DDR3 model type and 1600 megahertz bus speed. This is the notch which is mentioned here. This is because the location of the notch is different. Okay, DDR3 RAM may have notch here, DDR4 may have notch here. Okay, so when you insert here, it may not match, it will not get fit, and it will cause issues. So whenever you buy RAM, you have to make sure if your motherboard supports DDR3 or DDR4 model. So every RAM will have different voltage, 3.3 volts, 2.5 volts, and DDR2 supports 1.8 volts. In case if there is no sticker on your RAM and you cannot find it, depending upon the volts, you can find it. So open the motherboard. On the motherboard, you can find the voltage here, mentioned here. Okay, then you can find what type of RAM is used on your motherboard. So HD RAM will have 168 pins. So how to know the pins? Let me show you. These gold color pins are calculated. So you don't have to count the pins. Here it will have a number. Okay, if you rotate the RAM, okay, it will have 1 and 92. Again, it will have some number, 72, something like that. Again, 240. So depending upon the number, you can know what type of RAM it is used. So earlier HD RAM used to have 168 pins, and it used to have two notches, two cuts on it, and it was used in P1, P2, P3. Okay, and DDR1, DDR2 RAM will have only one cut, but it will have a different type of pins. it will have like DDR1 will have 184 pins and DDR2 will have 240 pins on it. So HDRAM features. So in HDRAM it was available like 32 MB RAM, 64, 128, 256, 512. So up to 512 HDRAM was available. Okay, and this was a bus speed which was available for HDRAM. In case if you are using DDR1 RAM, we used to get from 128 MB RAM, 256, 512, 1 GB and 2 GB, and this was a bus speed available. And this is a DDR2 RAM, guys. 256, 512, 1 GB, 2 GB and 4 GB, and this is the bus speed. For example, I have a motherboard with DDR1 RAM slot. Okay, I have only 1 GB RAM, 1 GB RAM with 3 megahertz speed. I want to upgrade my RAM. Okay, if I want to upgrade to 4 GB, it is not possible because 1 GB, because DDR1 RAMs supports up to only 2 GB. So I have to get one more 1 GB RAM with same bus speed. In case if I'm going to buy different bus speed RAM, so what are the bus speed we have available here? 400 megahertz. Okay, if I'm going to buy 400 megahertz bus speed RAM, my it will show 2 GB RAM. Okay, my computer will show 2 GB RAM, but whenever the data will transfer, it will be slow. So we have to make sure the bus speed needs to be same if you want good performance. Okay, so here let me explain. If you are using DDR1 RAM, it supports up to 2 GB. If you are using DDR2 RAM, it supports up to 4 GB. DDR3 supports up to 16 GB. DDR4 supports up to 64 GB. Okay, so if you want to know what RAM being used on your motherboard, what you can do is, you don't have to open your machine to check it. You can install one application called CPU ID. okay, so this is the application, guys, which you can use. Here you can find the model number of your CPU, Intel Core i7, and it has 2 cores and 4 threads. If I click on memory, this is a DDR4 RAM and 16 GB is the memory which I have, and dual channel. So thank you for watching, guys. Please do subscribe, like and share it with your friends. Meet you next class. Thank you.